Goal. So today we'll be talking about a very interesting topic for many people, especially the ones that are trying to build their names or the ones that are trying to market their business. The topic today is about marketing and the importance of marketing for your business success and your success in life. Marketing has changed dramatically in the previous period. We have new form of media that people are watching using their smartphones. We have social influencers, and we have many programs that are outside the normal TV broadcast. Things like that has affected how people think about marketing, and it has also affected how we do marketing. So let me give you a brief story of how people started to do business and how they slowly started to evolve over time. So let us start from the village community. So thinking about a village community, someone think about there will be a particular need for this village. Maybe they need some kind of dry cleaner, or they need some tailor, or maybe they need need a barber. And so the barber opened a small shop, and he says, okay, this is the place where I cut the hair for people. People start walking beside the shop, and they know that the barber is working here. So this is the first way of knowing that there is a business in this place, which is about location. So in order to enhance his appearance, his outside appearance and image as a small shop, he put a big sign, a clear sign, and he tried to use a different name. And by doing this, he just want to say for the people that they know him, I am available here. And for the people who are just passing by his shop, that I am a barber and this is my shop. So this is the basic way of marketing, and he depends on his contacts, and he depends on the quality of his service. So now at this stage, the barber just start to work hard in order to cut the hair of the people in a good way and try to promote himself as the best barber in town. With time, things change. The barber want to open in a new place, and he thinks that he want to move to the next level. He does not think that only the location is the most viable option for my marketing success. He start to think, maybe I can make a TV ad, or maybe I can make a billboard. So he go to the one of the famous billboard in town, and he say, the best barber in town is located in Area A. So everyone knows that the best barber is located in Area A. However, only people who are really willing to who value their hair or who value their appearance will go this way, will go to this barber because it's very far from their homes. Maybe they think the price is high. Maybe they think the service will be different than they expect. So here, the barber managed to build his show, his name or his brand, but or the business, but he could not actually transfer this to sales. So people start knowing about him, but a small amount of them will start using his service. If his service was superior and his product was superior than other products in the market, then everyone will start telling about him, this is fantastic. Then you will have this customer retention, will have this customer loyalty, and people will start coming back again and again and again and again. So that's the start. So now things has changed. He want to expand his business. He make a TV ad, and with the TV ad, he become popular. He people know about him. He start to building name. He's the best barber in town, and so on. And some people who want the best service will always come to him, and they would always should be convinced that this service is really the superior service. Think about things like BMW. Things like Mercedes. Think about like these top brands. Things like about Apple and so on. Because other brands actually, focus on the cost, that they say we provide the same service but at cheaper price. So now the marketing mix in terms of quality and price always and functions and the different aspects always play a significant role in the conversion and in the retention of customers. So if you had a lot of customers and these customers are convinced that your product is the superior product and your prices is the superior prices, they will always come back to you as much as they need. And this is a very important thing, as much as they need. So the market will demand, always dictate how much these people will actually need your service. Regardless how much marketing you put into it, you might pull the market a little bit, but it would be very hard for you to satisfy, for example, it would be very hard for you to expand the market, except if you have managed to satisfy different needs in the same time. Think about the smartphone. It has satisfied the use of email and the use of telephone and the use of a media player as well. So because the iPhone or the smartphone was wonderful as a medium player, was wonderful as a communication tool, was wonderful as a computing tool, was wonderful as a camera, people start thinking this smartphone actually address different needs on the same time. And this is why actually smartphone has expanded, and this is why the market of smartphones was really the highest in years, not because the smartphone was the best phone. No, it was because the smartphone was a very good phone, a very good communication medium, a very good media player, a very good camera and editing tool. So because he combined all of these services in a very simple, compact way of technology, people started thinking, that a smartphone worth buying. The smartphone is actually a great investment. It delivers different needs in the same time. So now things even expanded and started to change dramatically. People start to think about Facebook and Google and Snapchat and the new social media and to try to put their names to be known through these mediums. And now the marketing cost started to dramatically expand and started to somehow become highly inefficient. So and these tools usually help you build your name, not actually build your sales, because building your sales is highly associated with a superior product, with a superior service, with a need, with a market. Building a name through the different social media or building a name through different marketing tools will help you to build your name in a way that can be that people know what is your service, what is your company, what are you doing. Not necessarily they will buy. Some of them, small amount, will start buying. If these people were convinced about your work, then they start expanding again and again and again. And I see honestly that most media based marketing is highly associated with brand awareness rather than conversion rates. That's my opinion. I might be wrong, I might be right, but that's my opinion. So everybody can have his opinion and everybody can control his money in the way that he likes. That is being said, we move to the other thing. So in the past period, if someone you trust told you that we have purchased this item from this place and we think it's a very good place, and if you trust this person and if you trust his judgment, then you will always say, yes, maybe, most probably, then this person is right and I should follow, and most probably will end up buying the same thing because this is something that you trust. And with the social influencers and with the people that you watch in the media, I have to tell you the truth, that it's very rare that actually you have a likeness or a love relationship between the person who is trying to do the media and between the person who are trying to promote himself and the viewers, between social influencers and their viewers. The social influencers, yes, people enjoy their content. They have curiosity about what they are doing. People has a need to fill their time, but they can really address the need for building a name and building awareness about a particular brand or about a particular product, but it's very rare that they can build a conversion rate. So if you have a new announcement about your business, if you have a new product, if you have a new package and you just want people to know it, so if they need such a service and you think there is a market for it and you just want to reach that market, yes, you can use these people, you can use social influencers. But if you are really looking to expand your sales and to build your sales and you are not sure really whether your market do exist or does not exist and whether there are enough people who are really interested in your product or service, social influencers will only build your brand. And this is similar similar to TV channels and so on. I agree that TV, social influencers are more effective than TV. So at least people watch these people on a daily basis. They just they do not watch an ad in a interrupted way. So when they watch TV, usually they watch the things that they like, and suddenly there is an ad in the middle of the movie or there is an ad in the middle of the program and they just want to skip the ad quickly. However, when they watch social media and when those social media promote your product, they put it in a way that is natural of the medium. Of the media they play, and usually they play their story, they play what they are doing in their lives, and they are showing that we have an interesting life, and they are showing that we are wonderful, we are beautiful, and so on. And yes, people like it, and yes, sometimes people are very eager and very curious and very jealous and very hateful or very or with a great affection to these celebrities. So yes, so it depends which one you are, which part in the business you are. Are you trying to build your awareness? Are you trying to build your name? Are you trying to build your brand? Or are you trying to build your sales? Are you trying to build conversion rate? And it's a very long path between building your name, building your service, building your brand, and actually reaching the market and reaching customers. So yes, marketing efforts can be really helpful, but it's very important that people has actual need and they have used their service and it has worked and they loved your service or they loved your product. So increasing your sales is not only about marketing. Increasing your sales is also about product and about service and about people being convinced that your product or service actually worth having, or your product or service actually delivers the delivers the aspect that it says it will deliver. So that's two part of the business. Now about how you plan, how you develop a marketing plan. So in the beginning, you should start thinking about, yes, I will always need to build a brand, and I will always need to know to locate my market and to understand what type of market do I have, what kind of individuals are interested in my product or service, and I need to understand when they will buy the product, when they will use the service. And this is highly associated with several aspects. It's associated with your superiority or the superiority of your product or service, but it's also associated with time. So if people want to use the product today, they will buy it today. And if your product satisfies their need, and they know about you, if they actually will buy the product once in their life, you don't buy a trainer's clothes every day, and you don't buy running shoes every day. So if you want, when the time is right and when you decide to buy a running shoes, and usually this is associated with an event, so you want to participate in a marathon or you want to participate in some kind of a sporting event, and you think, yeah, I need the gadget, I need to look nice, I need to look cool, so you start buying the products, or maybe I need to train and so on. So when you start engaging in a sport activity, maybe at that time you start thinking about buying a sport shoes or buying a running shoes. So understanding when people will make the purchase decision, so at what moment and why they have made this decision and what is the urgency of this decision, because many things that people say they will do, eventually they do not do, and what is the motivation behind that will actually be a fundamental aspect in your success or your failure in terms of business and in terms of and in terms of business and in terms of buying your product. So that was my talk about marketing product and the mix between different aspects of marketing and the story of the barber who moved from a small sign in the shop to make a social media campaign, and where is the conversion rate, when the conversion rate will happen and when the sales will be up. And I would always say that if you have something that is really innovative, if you have something that is really cool, and people think that this is some kind of a superior technology, and people know about your name, you will always be, people will always remember you, and people will always reach you out in order to promote, in order to buy your service or your product. So focus on building a superior technology rather than building a name, because this is actually a difficult aspect, having the 10x superior product. And with that, I definitely think that the part of the business is highly associated with a superior product rather than marketing, especially if you are looking for expansive sales. That has been said. That's my talk for tonight. We'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place, 8:45 in English Amman time, 8:30 in Arabic Amman time. Have a great evening.